esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
And we're back once again, ladies and gentlemen, with the second map here in the winner's bracket between NaVi and Fnatic. So welcome to the show. That first map was definitely not boring, Seminar and Mineta. It didn't go to 16-14, but I think we got our money's worth in terms of action.
No, that definitely delivered. There's no doubt about that. Obviously, you could get miffed about a couple of mistakes made by both teams at certain points, but no, still very entertaining game. And I think it's okay to say that Fnatic definitely deserved the win on Mirage.
Yes, I mean, you know, with so many things, and I guess in any kind of competition, that you know, you can win by making sort of the least mistakes or having the other team make more mistakes, whichever way you want to phrase it. But that's definitely a thing. And Fnatic did not give that many openings. They had some mistakes too, sure. But I think Navi's happened in a couple of rounds that were very, very important. Perhaps most notably the second round of the first half, where they lost to a straight B push that... they definitely shouldn't have lost that easily. They could have lost it anyway, because we all know how powerful the CZ can be. But it's more like the way they lost it was kind of silly of them. And that cost them at least a couple of rounds, and probably gave Fnatic a very good, strong economical start as well. So that might have been probably... I mean, we sort of forgot about that towards the end, because there were a couple of mistakes since. But I think that was one of the more serious ones anyway. While we're waiting for everyone to join up here, we've got seven people on the server. Reminder again that we're doing a giveaway of one of these Cyrexes here that we got gifted to us by Stony Maloney, who's one of our very cool subscribers. And we're also giving away one of these StatTrek AWPs, which is a factory new one, graphite. So you can win one or the other, and that's pretty much it. So that's for the sub team for being just generally very cool and helping us out with the channel. If you're just joining us, then remember as well, there is a Facebook giveaway at the bottom of the stream. You can go and click a link down there, and you can win all sorts of cool stuff, including an AK Racing chair. So if you haven't done it already, it's an easy thing to go and like the page. And that's for everyone, not just subscribers, but everyone can go and win there. So 9 people on the server. You said it earlier, Ben, that there's a good chance that... Well, there was a chance anyway that Fnatic could end up 2-0-ing an RV. And because they already won on Mirage, I'd say that chance has increased a lot now that we're on Fnatic or on Inferno.
Yeah, I definitely think so. From what we've seen out of Fnatic on Inferno as of late, it's been very, very good, in my opinion. And even though NaVi beat Hellraisers earlier today on Inferno, I wouldn't say they were stellar by any sense of the word. So they looked a bit shaky, and with how shaky they looked at times on Mirage, I'd have to give the upper hand to Fnatic, especially with it being their map pick.
Yeah, I definitely concur. And I would say, I mean, that match against Hellraisers was a little bit tricky, because what happened is actually that it was 11-4 in favor of NaVi when they were on the CT side. And I think that means if they had won the pistol round in the second half, it could have been like, you know, 16-4 or 16-6 or something.
Yeah.
But the fact that they didn't, and that's where the shakiness or the wobbliness comes into play, is where they didn't win the pistol round, and then they had a really hard time recovering, and it went to 16-14. They very nearly lost that map.
Yeah, and that's also one of the cool things about this Fnatic team, is that they've been notorious for getting off to bad starts, according to Devilwalk. So the fact that they're always able to bounce back, that's just a great asset to have. And from what we've seen from NaVi, they get shaken up. And that's obviously a great advantage for Fnatic to have going into this game.
All I'm thinking about right now is Fnatic's play on B between Ulfmeister and Krims. Because that the last performance, the last time we saw them really play Inferno, it really seemed like those guys were indomitable on that site. Do you guys share the same opinion?
Yeah, they really locked it down, and that's another thing that's worth talking about, I suppose, is that Krims did really well on Mirage. Ulfmeister, I'd say he just had an average performance. I don't want to call it bad, but it was sort of, you know, average, and compared to himself, I guess it was, you know, a little bit below his own level, which is not necessarily that bad, because all it means is that if he's going to step it up and play that well on Inferno, then suddenly Fnatic, I think, could come off to a brutal start.
I think Olafmeister, on Mirage at least, was playing more of a... at the beginning on the T side, it seemed like he was the one who was kind of leading a lot, and so ate a lot of the damage most of the time. And then on CT side, it seemed like he was playing more of the role, like, I'm going to float back around and kind of plug the gap when one is formed, but his teammates were all hitting shots, so he never really got the time to shine.
Yeah, I think he at the half, he had 5 frags. I think after the T side, like five, and he ended up with 17 or something at the end of the game. So... You know, he did what he had to do on the A bomb site. It's not like Navi had a single easy round towards that A bomb site.
No.
At all. So, yeah, I think he definitely got into it as the game went along. And, well, if they get to start on the CT side, I think you're going to see Crimson Olaf make it really hard for Navi to do anything at all towards B.
Yeah, I think that's what it's down to. And then the question is, if you want to go A instead, are you going to run into JW's AWP or Pronax and maybe Flusher doing something, you know, some sort of cheeky setup? There's a lot of great things working for Fnatic here. But the knife round is live, and if you're just joining the show, then welcome to Room on Fire. This is the SLTV Star Series Finals, and we're at the first day. There's another whole day tomorrow where we're going to be covering another 3 best of 3 games, and it's going to be a great amount of fun. But right now we have Navi and Fnatic in a best of 3, and we're on the second map right here. So if you're just joining, then a big welcome to all of you, and thank you for tuning in.
Yeah, welcome everybody.
It seems like the most...
Go ahead and we have to give the advantage to Fnatic right now, because Navi haven't really had a stellar performance on Inferno, at least today. They did struggle quite a bit versus Hellraisers, who aren't... It's not like Hellraisers would give it away for free, but still, it was a bit of a harder fight than I thought Navi would have on the map. So Fnatic, the last time we saw them play, I think they just did a stellar job. The big thing here is that Navi win which side they get to start on. So they do get that CT start here for Navi on home turf.
Yeah, and if they win the pistol round and don't lose the anti-ecos, that really means something. But until they actually do that, it's still a little bit questionable. Because if Fnatic win the pistol round, then they're going to be great. They don't mind starting T at all. We shall find out.
I think Fnatic are fine with starting on the T side. They seem like a pretty well-versed team, so I don't think they're going to be... Debbie Downers about it.
No.
I think for Navi, on Navi's end, it's just a really good thing to start down the CT side, because I think they need to ease their way into the game and get a feel of things before... just basically just wait for Fnatic to run into them instead of having to chase after someone like JW towards the A-bomb site. That could be pretty frustrating if you don't figure him out just right away.
Yeah, and, you know, JW is playing so well on Mirage, and that's a scary thought, because it only becomes more tricky on a map like... Not more tricky, but it becomes just as tricky on a map like this, I would say, because there are so many positions he can take up. So, you know, if he kills you from one position in one round, you can be pretty much sure he's not going to be in the same position next round, but he's going to be somewhere else, and there you just have no idea. So, you're right, they don't want to play that mind game with JW. They just want to deny him, basically, make sure he can't do what he does.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to be curious to see if he's going to be as aggressive changing up his strats. It does seem like when he does get that AWP, he has been less predictable with it than he has in the past. Rather than just going apps every single round, he has started to change it up and, you know, maybe take the fight down mid more often or go over to B with it more often as well.
God, Aqua Chicken is back.
Is Aqua Chicken back?
Yes.
Oh. The return.
Is that a sign?
I don't know.
Is that an
omen? Who's that going to favor? I don't know. I can't read these animals.
Who played the last time Aqua Chicken was around?
Damn, I can't even remember.
Did
who
Navi
played
play?
Last time Aqua Chicken?
I can't remember. I wish I did, but obviously
that
he's
was,
getting
that
along
was a while
just
ago.
Fine with the chick with the fish. Things are looking great down here. I'm just enjoying this.
Yeah, well, I think we're in for something good then. I think we're in for a treat. Aqua Chicken doesn't just show up in any game.
It must be, yeah, you're right, it must be
a sign.
It's like in Game of Thrones when they had that red comment, right? It means something big is happening. Nobody really knows what it is, but definitely something big is happening.
Oh, yeah.
Well, guys, we're getting into the pistol round now. So, Navi on the CT side to start.
Oh, a little bit of robot
they
on
have
your
in
end,
mind.
I think. Oh, it's gone again. We're fine. We're fine.
Alright, Pronax. Pronax is cool. I mean, he actually picks up a Molly and a Smoke right now. And Crims, Smoke, Flash, Flash. I'm really curious to see exactly where Fnatic are going to take this, because that Molly could have so many purposes here. So many uses.
See, he's getting chased down. He's going to have Starix there to help him out. A grenade will follow as well, but a lot of good damage dealt to Seize. And Starix isn't able to retaliate quite yet. And they're very close here. They're still fighting, Na'Vi. They're not afraid to take this battle. And that might be a big mistake. They are bringing in some backup too, but I don't know about this. I feel like Fnatic, if they go for B right now, they might have a good shot of doing it. Starix does have a smoke, and if it goes up in time, it can make a difference, but smokes aren't as effective in pistol rounds as they are in rifle rounds. Just not quite the same.
No, but the smoke is going to go down to cut off CT spawn. Is Flusher going to be able to rush through here fast enough, though? There are two guys holding. Starix is going to be watching first, and Zeus alive in shadow. He's already putting damage out there, and he's still not dead. Zeus alive is a huge deal here for Fnatic.
Yeah, he's going to have time to read up, but they will find him, and that's Crims with the kill now. It's back into a 4-on-4, and the bomb will go down, and look how low Na'Vi are on health here. And they're going to find Starix as well, so now it is a 2, well, basically a 2-on-4. Seized is very low on health, and Edward's going to get tagged to the face as well, long distance, and that is definitely going to be the round for Fnatic. No chance here for the remaining Na'Vi members. And, I mean, I think it came down to, you know, the smoke is it's good, but it just doesn't have the same holding power as when you have a rifle placed on the other side. And they couldn't do anything, you know, they put up the smoke, but it didn't help them one bit.
Yeah, well, in addition to, well, if you only have a smoke, right, you, as you said, you need a rifle. Otherwise, you're going to need anti-flashes and whatnot to really hold people back. And Fnatic with the Molotov down and by new boxes, then, you know, they have a pretty clear idea of where they want to look and where they think Na'Vi players could actually be hiding. And that makes it so much easier for them, even when running through smokes.
I really like how Na'Vi, or how Fnatic rather, have played this round as well, making sure that Na'Vi can't push down on them aggressively anywhere with the pre-nades as well. Seize with the jump, swag, and he's not going to get the kill. Pronax catches him mid-air. And now Starix down to 10 HP after getting a frag of his own. We're into a 4-on-4, but the damage has been dealt here. Fnatic, I don't think they're going to let this go.
Starix is not in a great spot right now. Edward would be great with a crossfire, but I don't think Fnatic are going to allow them one. I think they're probably going to grenade them out of here, and actually Flush is going to straight headshot him, but even without it, you see the smoke that's going up right here would have denied Edward anyway. That would have left Starix alone. He's still in the corner hiding, and he wanted to get more than just maybe one kill, and in return he gets none at all. Zeus trying to deny the bomb plant, but Guardian is going to be alone, and I guess going to try and save the armor he has.
Yeah. No, it makes sense for him. Four guys alive on that B site. Unfortunately, Zeus got caught on the edge there of the coils. Just missed his jump. I mean, that cost him maybe half a second. And that half a second's difference probably means he can deny that plant or at least get a kill before getting caught by Pronax. So, really close call there. Zeus just barely falling short at the end. But Fnatic will pick up a second round. They do manage to survive the anti-eco, basically. I think that's the biggest part here for Fnatic. Getting rid of Seized so early as well, that was a big deal, managing to get rid of him so quickly from behind sandbags at the top of B.
Yeah, very, very important stuff. No crossfire setup, and just a really great round from Fnatic. They managed to hold on to it, and that's pretty important. We've seen how devastating it can be if you lose these antique rounds.
Absolutely, and especially the fact that they pick up Seized behind the sandbags also kind of negates the effect, well, how effective that pop flash is going to be from the Na'Vi member on site.
And actually, they are going to try and pop flash their way in again here, so let's see if it's going to work better this time. They're already taking some damage, and Guardian is sort of ready with it. This time, they might actually go for sort of a dual push, as they got both Starix and Edward down there. Oh, sorry, Starix and Seized. I'm just waiting for it. There's the flashbang, and now they're going to push, and they're going to find nobody.
This is good information, though. The thing is, they can't be sure. They have to kind of hang around here. And in the meantime, Fnatic are working their way up to the A site. Now they've heard the steps. Zeus has communicated to his teammates that, yes, Fnatic are already up quad. They're wrapping around onto site. And Na'Vi are going to have to just try and close in once Fnatic get the bomb plan at this point.
And Na'Vi, really unfortunate timing for them. They had a nice idea with Guardian up in the apartments. Then that was pretty interesting what they tried to do. But doesn't work out so well for them. Edward's going to take a fight and will down JW, but he only had a CZ. And right now, Fnatic just need to sit tight, and they should be able to pick up the kills easily enough here. They do lose a couple of players, and actually now it's a 1-on-2 for Starix. He doesn't have a kit, but he's going to try and look for crims anyway. Just good damage done here to Fnatic, and maybe the Swedes throwing away a few too many rifles in this round, I would say.
Well, Pronix did not have a rifle.
Yeah, Pronix, I think.
Yeah, Pronix and Pronix and JW was still on CZs. But I still actually think they gave away too many kills. JW definitely should have had Edward. He actually let him get around the corner up in apartments, and then he did a silly pre-fire for no good reason. And before he just died.
There was one CT holding by a little pit, and then there was Guardian up in the apartments, and this guy over here by a little pit, he could have stayed and waited for Fnatic. What actually he did is he rotated over and met up with Guardian coming out of Boiler Room, and I think they wanted to try and sandwich. If there was someone going quad, they would have been able to sandwich them, so that's not a bad move from Na'Vi, but as it were, the whole of Fnatic actually rotated towards Archway, so they completely missed the Fnatic team, and that's interesting. Quick trade over on Banana, Flusher for Starix. Oh, sorry, Pronex for Starix.
Damage dealt already. JW is still looking for a frag, and he's going to find it on Zeus, and he's going to clear out Seized as well. One was not enough. JW has shown up, and there's the speed up here as well. Right now, Na'Vi aren't quite sure exactly what's going on, because the smoke has gone down to cut off CT from Banana, and Guardian is waiting on the other side of it, but he doesn't hear any steps. He doesn't hear anybody speeding up, so Na'Vi still can't quite be sure what's going on. They haven't heard the bomb plant either.
They definitely haven't. Edward is far away, so unless Guardian just steps it up here and gets a quick double kill or something like that, it's probably not going to work out. And he actually gets tagged very low. He's going to pick up the one, but that's not enough. He needed to get at least two to make this work. Now, by the time Edward gets here, they're going to not just have the bomb down, but they should be in some pretty decent positions to actually defend here. So there's the bomb plant happening. Edward tries to sneak through the smoke. Crims is already looking. Edward comes through, and this is a terrible one-on-two for him.
No, it's not looking likely here. Olafmeister still alive behind new boxes. Edward just alive in yellow, trying to find an angle to work here, but the perfect crossfire is set up, and it's Olafmeister and Crims playing it as well. The teamwork between these two is fantastic, and I can't imagine them making the mistake. Look at how smart they're playing it. They aren't giving Edward a target. He never has anybody to shoot at. They just sit back behind those angles, behind those boxes, and just wait and make it so that Edward has to come to them or run away like he's doing now.
Yeah, and I would say that's what I expect from Fnatic at this point. I think if they start making mistakes in situations like that, that would be really grave. But they just don't. Edward does the best he can and steals an AWP and runs away. That's 4-0 now for Fnatic. And yeah, great start for the Swedes.
The question is now, well, Fnatic are still going to have plenty of money. That's not the problem. JW, not enough money for an AWP, though, so he will just be holding on to the CZ, it looks like. Still pretty potent. Na'Vi are going to go for a force buy, though, and Na'Vi are going to go for a bit of their canned aggression straight down mid, and it's only a quick one-for-one trade. Zeus with one headshot, but then Edward comes in and gets caught. So not the best trade that Na'Vi were hoping for there.
No, definitely not. I mean, they killed one guy with a CZ, and in turn they lost a rifle and Edward, and they're on the CT side, so I'd say Fnatic definitely very happy about that trade. It does kind of force them to slow down, because now they're wondering, did anyone else, while we were all focused on the middle, did anyone else creep up anywhere? But they have a good lockdown on them. I mean, they have Olafmeister covering the apartment, so I think Fnatic know a lot about what's happening here. Guardian misses a shot that he probably normally wouldn't, and that's going to give Fnatic some map control back.
Well, that's a bit of a problem here. They don't want to be allowing the Swedes any kind of room to work with. Seized is right on the other side of the smoke at Arched. He's hearing them walk by, and is he just going to go for it or not? He's just waiting right now. He doesn't want to throw anything away by pushing through that smoke and walking into the barrel of a gun. But Guardian is still alive on this A site, and he finds the angle, catches Pronax as he rounds the corner.
Yeah, and up in apartments, he's going to spot Olafmeister as well. Zeus doing a huge amount of work down from the pit here, and that should give Na'Vi the round. Crims is going to go down. Zeus picks up a triple, but I actually think he can almost be credited for the kill that Guardian got as well, because he actually distracted him enough for Guardian to hit that shot. So, well played, Zeus. That was a sick round from him.
See how important that pip position is, really, on a map like Inferno. it buys so much for your teammates, and it diverts so much attention from the opponent that it's unreal. So if you play that position correctly, you're going to be in a great spot regardless how many people are actually coming towards you.
Yeah, it's been proven time and time again. Fnatic is a team that's pretty good normally at dealing with some guy in the pit, because they tend to smoke them off or just otherwise take care of them, but this time it wasn't an option. They were focused on something different.
I'm still looking at how things are going to be holding here. It's still a 2-1. It's a 2-3 situation right now, but we do have Seized rotating over to support the A side at this point, because Na'Vi have smoked off the bottom of Banana, a go-to play now on Inferno when you're playing CT. Guardian holding towards Arch with his AWP is going to have the opportunity to peek out Pronax. Pronax trying to get around that corner fast enough, but he gets caught and Seized, peeks forward and drops the bomb carrier and gets Crims as well, poking out from Boiler. Two big frags there by Seized.
I was surprised he got the second kill. That was pretty impressive. That looked like he should have probably gone down. Now they control the bomb in the middle, and Fnatic are going to have a hard time getting into this. And even worse still for the Swedish team is they can't put down the bomb, which means, I mean, they'll definitely, I think even with the bomb plant, they'd be ecoing the next round, but now they will have even less money. So this should be the chance for Na'Vi not just to get to 2-4, but probably get even closer than that, which is good news, obviously. They're a map down.
Exactly right. Edward will find the last frag on Wolfmeister, but losing control that early on is a real problem here for Fnatic, and the money, no plant for them. So they're going to slowly give more and more momentum to Na'Vi here, seeing as how Na'Vi now get to deal with an anti-eco round. If they play it right, they live with four guys maybe, and still continue to build a bank. So now Fnatic have kind of lost that opportunity to get a lot of early momentum by breaking Na'Vi's money, or keeping it broken, rather. Now Na'Vi are going to get to a point where it's just going to be back-to-back buy rounds, and so life gets difficult for Fnatic. It's no longer an easy road.
Yeah, good grenade damage done early on here, but they keep pushing up behind this. Molotov's going to rain down here, and Seize is ready to pick up the eco frags, and he's going to get four of them. He's looking for the ace, and flushes out here with just a Glock. Look at Seize. He can feel it coming. He's actually going to go for it as well, and that would definitely be very nice. He is going to pick up all five members and put himself at 10-1-4. So, I mean, eco frags, we generally rate them a little bit lower, but in terms of confidence and a confidence boost to Seize, is definitely not bad.
Oh yeah, it doesn't matter if they have weapons or not. If you take down the entire team on your own, that's definitely a good feeling and definitely boosts your confidence. And, well, I don't think it's going to hurt, but it's not like the B bomb site has been really the biggest issue, I think, so far for Na'Vi, at least when they have been doing their standard two-man setup there.
They've been doing a decent job, but Fnatic, I mean, just like earlier, I suppose, on this map, if they get up to 5 or 6 rounds and win the pistol round in the second half, they're going to be in a great spot. So they're not far off right now. Seized, great flashbang in, and he actually gets a double kill. He's just playing like a monster right now with the help of Starix over here. So you're right. Maybe you are right, Vendetta. Maybe it's not such a weak spot right now. That was a pretty brutal defense. Offense, even.
Well, what is scary right now is, you know, we talked about this at the beginning of this series, how important Seized can be for Na'Vi. The more momentum that Seize starts to pick up, the more dangerous Na'Vi gets, in my opinion, because Seize takes point then, and then you still have to worry about Guardian. So this is now going through Fnatic, where they're just like, they're probably not registering who's doing most of this damage, but still, they're going to have to worry about having to deal with Seize and Guardian and potentially Edward as well.
Fnatic are going to, I mean, it's a 5-1-3, but they're going to try and recommit to the bomb site, see if they can get in here. They've thrown some interesting smokes that actually prevent Starix from just headshotting them in here. And in the background, Seize is going to burn to their fort. So Flusher does go down, and Starix still alive here. 20 seconds left. Backup should be coming, but somehow it's very far away, and Starix has to do everything on his own, which he will. So that's great, but I'm wondering why Na'Vi took so long to get here.
Doing what they do best. JW runs out of bullets, though. That's a little bit unfortunate. He's going to get caught in the back. So he had the opportunity to get two, nearly dropping Starix down, but Zeus will save the day. Save the AWP for Guardian as well, which is going to be great to save the money. I don't think that's destined for Seized. Yeah, Seized is going to hand that off. Terrific money on Na'Vi's side right now. That's the big deal here, is that now they're all kind of floating, or four of them, you know, are starting to get close to that 10k mark. If they win this round, they'll be past it. So this is really tough for Fnatic. Throughout the rest of this half, Na'Vi should have pretty solid money going through it.
Yes, they should. 4-4, and it's been equalized, and we'll see if they can keep training it up like this. I mean, if it finishes 11-4, we did point out earlier, Na'Vi had a hard time closing the game, even at an 11-4 finish against Hellraisers. I don't think it's going to be exactly easier against Fnatic, so right now I think 11-4 is a pretty good scoreline for Na'Vi to work against. Or towards.
Well, so far, this is actually going pretty good for them. They get two kills on this A site. Guardian is going to get caught and faced. Pronax with a great shot. M4A1 going to work. And now it's down to a 2-on-2. Seized will finally rush down to one. And Starix will rob him of the second kill. That was scary there for a moment for Na'Vi, I think. For a second at least, it looked like Fnatic were about to get a pretty easy plant.
Yeah, I that was way more than I expected him to get. Were you getting worried as well, Ben?
Yeah, when Guardian went down to Pronex, I was getting worried for NaVi until I saw that Pronex had the pack in pit. That would obviously make it hard for him to actually get out there or over to the bomb site safely.
Are they going to realize the Guardian's here? Good flank. Oh, grenade comes out from Guardian. Actually, will tag up Olofmeister. This 51 points of damage. So I thought maybe Guardian was going to stay with the AWP, but he's going to fall back and play it safely, which is maybe a smart idea.
Well, play patient at this point. Don't give away the free frag. And he changes up his position to the one he usually holds now, and he's going to hold it in tandem with Seized. So I really like this because he usually holds the angle from Arch. A little bit predictable, but still, Guardian is so quick that. Hell, you have to be pre-firing basically to catch him most times, as Pronex learned a couple rounds ago. So this is definitely going to be a situation where NaVi should be able to hold if it comes down to it. Fnatic are currently setting up with four guys outside of A in apartments, but they haven't committed yet, and they're actually working the bomb back down to the lower mid.
Oh, and Guardian ceased open up, and the interesting thing is that Starix is actually holding alone over here with no smokes or anything. He's hiding in the corner here. He's going to get flashed as well, and he will go down. That opens up the B bomb site completely. So NaVi, great hold on A, much worse hold on B. And now they really got to think about what they're doing. They're in a 3-on-4. If they lose one more member here, they could lose the round even with such a great start.
That's all about getting a quick kill here. But, oh, Flusha, again, kill through the smoke. He's going to shut down Seized. And this brings it back to a 3-on-3. Olofmeister has got the crossfire position over on Banana as well, making sure that nobody's going to go for the flank. But Guardian is going to be the point man here, I think. As soon as this smoke clears, he's going to be the guy with eyes on the site, and he finds the instant frag on Flusha.
Huge kill. Krim's now in the back here. Very hard for him to deal with. And Guardian will pick up the triple, and they will have enough time to defuse the bomb as well. Ven, how did you appreciate that? Once they got the two kills in the middle and make it a 5-on-3, why was nobody holding with Starix in this bombsite?
That's a good question. I think primarily it's due to the fact that Fnatic have been trying quite heavily to get mid control whenever NaVi has opted to play aggressively in Banana. So, because they do buy a lot of time, and they kind of force Fnatic to work towards the A-bomb site, because they have 3 smokes for the Banana push, right? So that's 17 times 3 that just basically erased unless you want to jump through the smokes and Banana. So they force them to work towards A. Obviously, if you stack up on A, then there's an easier chance to get a man advantage, which they did. So, I completely agree with that, but once you get that man advantage, then you're free to rotate over and play a standard 2-3 setup.
Oh my god. Edward just put some random shots through the smoke and tanked Olofmeister down to 1 point of health. I mean, he's in the bedroom. At this point, he could just lie down in this bed and relax for a while, because if he even steps on a splinter or anything like that, he's probably just going to die from that. That was so close to being a very, very random entry frag from NaVi's side. But again, they're leaving Starix alone, and he does have a smoke, but he has to put it up before they get in, and that might almost be too late.
That's going to be very close. Oh, the smoke from the mate from mid, however. That's basically what happened here. Guardian is going to go ahead and drop a smoke in front, so Fnatic are actually going to have to rush through the smoke if they want to make this happen. Seize is rotating into support as well as Guardian. They're all going to try and close the gap, and they take the fight. Seize dropped down to 1 HP as well.
Yeah, Guardian can't find a kill. Starix is still inside, and there's no bomb plant happening, and they spotted him. Now he has no chance to hide, and NaVi's B defense, I'd say, is very questionable at the moment. Guardian with a really interesting angle, but he can't find the kill. He spotted one guy. They definitely know where Flusha is, but all these smokes right now are working so well for Fnatic. NaVi are kind of out of it right now.
They certainly are struggling. It's not an easy job right now. Zeus is trying to push his way into construction. He's got a mate backing him as well, and Edward. They spot the Flusha out, trying to be cheeky behind the sandbags, and Flusha is just sitting there. Pronex is there to watch his back, and Pronex gets the kill on Edward. Zeus, not a whole lot he can do, and Guardian backing off as well. Olofmeister trying to hunt them down, and now Guardian is stuck behind the truck. Olof gets both frags, and this is now Fnatic with the 5th round on the board.
And
the...
No, go well, on.
Yeah. That was a really nice adaption from Fnatic because, well, as I talked about earlier, the fact that they've been forced to work towards A earlier, that made them kind of commit too hard towards the middle area, and Guardian and Seized has been able to pick up frags in mid, basically leaving Fnatic with one or two men down each and every time. This time, they basically just did the easy thing, which is wait out the smoke in Banana and went as a group without having lost a single man, without having committed anything towards A, and that worked out pretty nicely.
It definitely did, and I think NaVi might have also mistimed the smoke that went up, because Starix kind of felt like he was And without a smoke, Andrew, way too long.
Check out Seized right now. He's got a cool smoke. I haven't seen this angle before.
Oh. Well, we'll see where it lands. Alright, so smoking off sort of the middle of banana, and that's actually going to give them time to go and peek if there was anyone trapped on the other side of the car. They don't find anyone here, but now they're going to take up position. And there's a Molotov and a smoke on Starix.
That's very cool, but this is actually going to open it up. As soon as that smoke goes down, they leave it up for a few seconds and Fnatic push through. Starix at least gets a 1-for-1 trade, but they lose control of the B-bomb site. Seized is on the other side of the smoke.
Yeah, Guardian trying to put some shots through here, and Seized is going to go down to Crimson. Right now, NaVi have to make a huge adjustment to their defense, because the last three rounds, they've almost lost in exactly the same way, and that's a big problem. It has to change, basically, in the upcoming round. NaVi can still buy, which is very important here, but Fnatic are en route to a really, really great first half right now. It's a 2-on-2, and Crimson Olofmeister left with the bomb down.
Crim's alive, has spotted out a man. Guardian is going to look for the flank, but he's not going to be quick enough. Nade not going to do anything at all, and Olofmeister hiding behind new boxes. We'll pick off Edward as he tries to get up onto this site. But you're right, it's really nice timing, really, that's working out here for Fnatic. They've figured out that NaVi are leaving one guy there, and they've gotten the punish in two rounds running now.
It's good. It's definitely good timing for Fnatic, but more than that, I think it's the fact that Starix is alone all the time, and he doesn't get to use any of his grenades. Last time he died with the smoke still in hand, this time he died with smoke and Molotov. They're basically being allowed through way too easily. And that would be a different thing if there were two people holding, but when he's alone, it loses them the round almost instantaneously.
Yeah, I think Starix has been playing it too aggressively. Pretty much, when he gets picked off, it's at the point where he dies and the bombsite is lost.
Yeah.
He needs to make it so that even though he dies, he's bought enough time. So he needs to spot out people and then be able to survive for 5 to 10 seconds.
Yeah, I agree that there's definitely something has to change, and they have changed it luckily this time. Fnatic got the opening pick on Starix again, who was playing aggressively, and this time up in the apartments, we'll have to see if Olofmeister is going to get the kill. He will take down Seuss, and now things are looking great for Fnatic. Edward will return on one, comes out spraying, and Olofmeister's ready for it.
Yeah, and this is now a two-man advantage here for Fnatic. NaVi don't really have too much to put up a fight with. Guardian is actually electing to back off immediately and Seized as well.
Yeah.
So they aren't even going to go in for an attempt at this, although Seized does get a nice kill on Pronax. I just don't think that they're quick enough or they're close enough to act at this point.
No, definitely not. This is not over yet. We're in the 13th round. It's about to be 7-6, and I mean, can't really count NaVi out pretty much no matter what happens at this point. I mean, we still have a whole second half to play. But I would say so far they have lost three absolutely devastating rounds to that B push. And that's really crippled them. They reacted finally, but I think it might have been too late.
Well, they reacted, but Stark still got picked off. So, yeah, it hasn't really helped. The fact that they've adapted, because Starix is still getting caught out. And he's getting caught out in positions where his teammates have no way to actually trade on it.
Yeah.
So, in that sense, the changes that NaVi have made are more or less insignificant, but now they're leaving Seized all along towards the B-bomb site.
And what's really scary is that NaVi are now also out of money. Starix is coming back in again, and Seized is in the back as well. Now Smoke is going to go off here. And it's very standard stuff coming out. It's what they need to do at this point. But if NaVi lose this, it's probably going to be 9-6 in favor of Fnatic, and that's just way too much of a good score. If it finishes, 8-7, there's still a chance Flush is going to get forced out here, but Starix can't pick him up. And look how worried NaVi are about the B-bomb sign, and don't blame them for it. They're going to be flashed out onto Banana, and they get nothing for it.
Third man, Flusha.
And
just Seized. Flusha things.
Yeah, but it's definitely a situation where it's more Seized than Flush, I'd say. That last kill should have been kind of an easy pickup. I think this is where NaVi really start to crumble again, unfortunately.
It really seems like it, and it's the same thing each and every time. The NaVi players on B try to make an aggressive play, they get caught out, and the bomb site just flat out dies. And there's no way for any of the guys on the A-bomb site to actually help them out in any kind of way.
Yeah, I think it's been a couple of rounds since we identified what sort of the core issue is, but they're not able to adjust for it. They still keep losing the same way, and JW is going to find Edward and Guardian. 6-8 here is going to be the scoreline. And NaVi obviously forcing up whatever they can, which is not as bad as I thought, actually. I thought it would be much worse. They have lost 4 rounds in a row. And I believe 4 rounds in a row, more or less, to troubles at the B-bomb site.
Yeah. It's four B pushes.
Yeah, well, either
the thing is, 4 B pushes, but it still takes... I mean, the thing is that you still have to rely on Pronax and the Fnatic team figuring out the weakness. They spent the beginning of the half, they spent figuring out what NaVi were throwing at them, how NaVi were holding, and now Pronax kind of just zeroed in on the weakness, and they've just been exploiting it. So Fnatic, it's sure NaVi struggling somewhat, but also Fnatic making a right call and just figuring out how NaVi hold and taking advantage of it. And NaVi just haven't been able to adjust fast enough here to be able to recover any kind of balance in this half.
Yeah, that's what it's down to.
Yeah, there's definitely Fnatic making the adaptions that need to be made, and NaVi shouldn't allow more than 2 rounds in a row.
Yeah,
to really be able to, like, they shouldn't be able to get punished by what adaptation that Fnatic has made more than 2 times in a row before they figure out what they can do to counteract whatever is going on.
Yeah, I think that's a reasonable number to hit. You can lose 1 round and say, all right, you know, that might have just
been a fluke.
Yeah, that was a fluke, right? You lose the next round, you should be thinking, all right, we can't lose one more round like this. Flush just going to creep in and actually scope Sol right into the scope of Seize. That's very unfortunate. That would have been a sick opening. If they could have got that, it would have been a nice 1-on-2. Now, instead, Crims is alone in an awkward 1-on-2. And I'm wondering, I mean, I guess they do have them sandwiched in, but now that it goes down, it's a 1-on-1. I'm not a fan of how Seize played that.
That was really nicely done by Crims, though. Just, you know, going for the pre-fire. If he's going to sit there seized, he's going to get punished. And that was really nicely done there by Crims. Crims still has 2 nades to hold on to as well here. 2 flashes and a smoke. But rather than go for that, he's just going to opt to hold on to the rifle and wait for Zeus to go for the flank through. And he already knows where Zeus is coming from. He sees it coming from a mile away. And he even sees the gun barrel coming around the corner. Crims securing that 9th round for Fnatic going into this second half.
Yeah, and NaVi thinking, instead of having a 2-on-1 advantage, we're going to fight him one at a time instead. It makes much more sense. In the beginning, it makes sense for them to cover both bomb sites, but once they're in a 2-on-1, why not use that advantage? I really think NaVi are sort of... They're playing, you know, 5 1-on-1s, essentially, or trying to. Doesn't seem like there's that much communication going on.
Something is definitely not right with what NaVi are doing as of right now, but I don't think we really can fault the players. I think it's specifically Guardian and Edward who've been playing the A bomb site, because they've more or less just had to respond to hopeless situations for the better part of the game. So as soon as NaVi started losing rounds, and it was always towards the B bomb site, then they always came in late, because the bomb site was immediately lost. They have to fight through X amount of smokes and flashes, and Fnatic members have already gotten into proper afterplant positions. So, yeah, I would say it's all down to the play on the B bomb site, which seems kind of silly if you look at the scoreboard, but that's why stats aren't everything.
Stats definitely aren't everything, and I mean, it's definitely not over. I mean, 8-6 is sure it's bad, but we've seen greater comebacks on the terror side of Inferno, so I'm not ready to rule NaVi out at all. The problem is that Fnatic are not just a good terror-sided team here, as we can see. They've won 9 rounds, on the terror side, so that in itself is a big statement, but also they're pretty good on the CT side, so NaVi are going to have to bring a little bit more than their A game, I would say.
Yeah, they have the home turf, let's say that, right? Maybe the crowd chanting makes a difference here in this second half. NaVi certainly need every edge they can get, but going into this pistol round, now we have to see what they have in store for us here. Pronax already spotting one man in T-Pit that seized at the other side. Has to be careful he doesn't overstay his welcome, though, because Starx is lurking around the corner, and if Pronax overcommits, there's 3 guys ready to rush him down, but he backs off at just the right time.
Pronax going back down the middle. It's going to find the kill on Edwards. A very nice flick from Pronax. Edward was even sort of looking that way, but that was just way too fast. And that's going to give a really big opening here. Crims holding inside the bomb site. They might get an opening if they can kill Crims here. There's a chance they can get the bomb down. And Starix is in the middle, being really annoying. He's going to take down Pronax. And that has to commit a lot of resources now to dealing with Starix.
Oh, this JW deciding to take this single-handedly. He's going to find it. Olafmeister with 2 sick frags.
managing to pick two guys off a base site. Now Guardian is the last man alive. The bomb has been planted, but Guardian, he's in a 1v3 situation, and he has to set it up because I think they spotted him. Crims instantly catches him around that corner. But that was not how things were supposed to go. Olafmeister with those two headshots was huge.
It definitely was. Great round from Fnatic, and that's now going to put them in a very, very significant lead to the point where I am going to have a really, really hard time seeing how NaVi can possibly get back into this. I think Fnatic are routine enough and a strong enough team that they're not going to start making a lot of really silly mistakes. NaVi, on the other hand, they're actually going to be buying 4 Molotovs and a bunch of armors as well. They want to try and see if they can turn the tide really quickly here.
Well, you got the nades raining in already, and this might have definitely caught Fnatic off guard here, seeing as how NaVi get the plant. And that's the whole point of this buy for NaVi. Usually you would expect NaVi to be ecoing, maybe investing in some CZs, but then looking to buy in the round that comes. NaVi, unfortunately for them, they don't get big damage dealt before they get figured out. Fnatic now know, well, they invested in a lot of nades, and well, they're a little bit tougher now than they should be. What's going on here?
Well, this is the Ring of Fire coming in from, from NaVi.
They want to try and see if they can burn Crims and Olafmeister, but actually Crims and Olafmeister are in pretty good positions to deal with this because they're just looking at the smoke. So if they were back here and had to move out from the Molotovs that are going to be coming in, that would be different. But because they're already in good positions, it's going to be much trickier. And I think especially Olafmeister here is doing a great job with the positional play. Flashbang does go through, and he's actually going to get downed anyway. Crims up here will take a kill and goes for a second one. Got to be careful and maybe wait for his teammates, but he actually just gets the kill anyway. And Guardian, well, he's going to get the bomb plant, but he can't possibly defend this. He's going to go down. Great play from Crims. I thought actually that was a little bit too aggressive, but it worked out.
That was a sick play from Crims. The double shot, keeping his cool like that and getting a double kill with USP like that. That was really nice.
I think he got some help. I think he got some help with some nicely timed shots through the smoke from spawn there.
The crossbow. So,
yeah, it softened up a couple of targets excellent. When he went up with the USP. But for NaVi, that's still mission accomplished. They wanted the bomb plant and because they're going to force up.
They are going to force it up. Okay, then. Buying AKs for each other and then other people buying armor and then spreading it thinly enough here? Yeah. All right. Now we are going to go all in.
Yeah, this is all in. This is giving Fnatic 2 rounds, basically. Unless NaVi can get a plant in this round as well, which would be huge. JW is going to find Starx, though, at the beginning. That's the deagle down for NaVi. But more importantly, that was a full set of nades that aren't going to get used now. So NaVi lose a lot of value. I'm sure they would have rather had Zeus kind of camping out mid get picked off there.
It would have been marginally better. Certainly would have.
You have to wonder why they would have... I mean, why you would have Starx there. I guess the deagle is the one that is the thing that makes a difference, but... Information, right?
Yeah.
It is a big risk to take.
I'm actually kind of surprised that the... Well, we've talked about how Crimson Olafmeister were the impenetrable fortress at Gamescom on this B-bomb site, but NaVi really want to test the strength of that building.
Yeah, they do, and they're going to force their way in here. Crims gets a good spray. It's going to go down eventually, but that still leaves Olafmeister over by the flowers here. With the FAMAS in hand, he's going to spray down one and two. They just line it up for him, and it's going to be down to Guardian here in a one-on-four. Again, it's Guardian alone, and this time he can't even really put the bomb down easily. Olafmeister's going to come through, and he doesn't care about smoke. We'll pick up a quick triple and is just playing a great game. It actually is Crims and Olafmeister who've got a lot of kills, especially in the second half here. That's 12-6, and now NaVi have to eco. I mean, yeah. I think if they had won some of these rounds they had forced up, maybe we could have seen some sort of return, but because Fnatic basically just stood their ground, it's now even more unlikely than it was before that they were going to make a comeback.
Yeah, this is when life gets really difficult for them. If they'd at least gotten a plant in that round, we could have seen another force here, or a buy with AKs and limited nades. Flusha is going to take point pushing down, and Fnatic again going with a bit of the aggression, pulling a bit of a NaVi, in fact. Just kind of bullying their opponents right now. The NaVi love to do this sort of push around mid, throw their weight around, go for picks, and just shut down basically an ecoing team. It's a bit of a VP style as well. So Fnatic, they get the two-man advantage, and now they just kind of sit back and wait, make sure that NaVi have to come to them.
That's the right play to make at this point. Don't have to unnecessarily throw away weapons. You don't want to give NaVi any sort of opportunity or extra opportunity to actually get back into this.
No, definitely not. And they're not doing it either. Edward's going to go down, and it's Olafmeister and Crims. It's the tag team over on Banana that's going to be taking down the remaining players, leaving us at 13-6. Guardian has picked up an AWP, and 6-round difference is pretty huge. But what's even worse is I think Fnatic have at least 3 or 4 members that have a really good economy, which means it's not even like Na'Vi can just bank on winning a round or two and then force an eco. They're going to have to string together multiple rounds here to make it work.
And what's even worse for Na'Vi at this point is that even if they win a round, which is obviously their ultimate goal, they have to have people survive to actually be able to get a full buy-up in the next round. So they need to survive with 3 people or more to actually have full buys.
Oh, look at this from Crims. I'm actually loving this. I think this is a bit of a mind game. I don't think Na'Vi has... They could guess that someone might be here, but I think because they've already been moving or picking all that round, yeah, they're not going to look. They had all their attention focused on the top of Anana. So Crims picks up that kill basically for free, and Prolix is going to take down Starix. That was actually very smart movement from Crims. I like that.
No, I did like that as well. That was very clean work there. And now Na'Vi trying to build off of this. Nice nade there from Flush, a triple, dealing around 30 damage to each player there. That was brutal. But Na'Vi are going to hunt them down. They want payback for that. The question is, are they going to be able to get the frag? Flush holding hard around this angle, and he's got 2 guys here on the A site to help support as well.
Oh, he was just holding to look. Now he's actually going pretty aggressively, and there are 2... Well, he's going to pick up a kill anyway, and that's pretty nice. Edward goes down. Flusher, he wants the double, but he's not going to get it. Seuss will take him down, and Seuss has a lot of work to do, so he's going to repeat Golofmeister, and that will drop the bomb and leave Guardian alone in a 1-on-3.
Well, Guardian, is he going to be capable? Knows Olafmeister is there, goes for the shot, but he's not quick enough. Olafmeister already tagging him down, gets the frag, and puts Fnatic at 14 rounds, 1 round away from at least securing overtime. And Na'Vi, they have to force. They have to try and stop Fnatic from getting past that line.
14-6, and just 2 rounds away from Na'Vi losing 2-0 here in the upper bracket and being knocked down to play in the lower bracket against either MyXMT or Hellraisers, depending on who wins the match tomorrow. Flusher going hyper-aggressive here and catches Seuss off guard, and that's obviously a nice start. Actually, he's going to get a second one as well. Edward keeps pushing, and he was ready for it.
Oh, Flusher taking a lot of damage here. Guardian catching him out in apartments. Nicely done there by Guardian, but still, Flusha willing to take the damage, or basically deal the damage here. It's a 3-on-2 situation, and Na'Vi now down a man, and Guardian down half health. The smoke is down at bottom banana, but that's going to clear, and he goes for the pre-fire, nearly takes JW. Very close call there, and the smoke is going to go down to block him out again, once again forcing Na'Vi towards this A site.
Starix creeping up, actually almost spots off Olafmeister. That would have been a great opening kill, but Pronax is on the other side here, and he's going to go for it quick and does great damage already. Flashbangs his way in, and up from behind, JW's coming in, and it will be a great cleanup here for Fnatic. No chance that there was going to be anything wrong with that. 15-6, and there's just not a lot of money left for Na'Vi. I think we're looking at a 16-6 victory here for Fnatic.
Seems very, very likely at this point. Na'Vi... Obviously, they're going to be able to get something due to the round loss bonus, but it's not the greatest buy in the world. You see, they got Galils, so they can actually get a couple of nades as well, which I think is a smart choice. But yeah, this is it for Na'Vi. They have to make this work, and it has to work perfectly.
Flashbang goes in, and super aggressive move from Pronax is going to catch out Seized. That's very nicely done. I mean, it's Na'Vi are trying to set up for what may be the final push. They just get ran into by Pronax. He's going to pick up a second kill. Pronax on a rampage, finally going to get shot down, but he's already done so much, and the spray through the smoke from Flusher almost kills Seuss.
Oh, great potential here from Wolfmeister, but he can't get the job done. Guardian finds the headshot first. Flusher comes in, and Guardian is burning! Guardian burns to death! Wolfmeister gets him from the grave, and now we're into all 1v2. Seuss is alive in A apartments. The bomb is planted for him, but both members here for Fnatic, and now they know exactly where he is.
Yeah, and Seuss should just be waiting here. Fakus once, and Flusher... gonna go for it. He's so low on health. Flusher's down there, and he's gonna pick up the kill and make it a double. Well played, Fnatic. 16-6 victory for them, and even if they had lost that round, still really not much of a chance for Na'Vi to bring it back. So overall, just great play from the Swedish team.